Hello everyone, my name is Sergey Yastrebov, I'm a community lead from Facebook Developer Circle Moscow, and today I welcome you at the first day of Deep Learning Online Meetup. If you didn't see previous presentation where Ruslan Martinov talked about content recognition for music, or Sergio Garrido talked about generative model for tripler data, or Shreya Sharma talked about soldering cars, check out our YouTube channel. If during the presentation you would have some questions related to today's topics, you can use live chat. If you would have some questions while watching this presentation in record, use comments because live chat will not be available after live session is over. And now let me introduce our today's speaker, Eliya Nachmani, who will talk about separation of mixed audio content. Welcome, Eliya. You can start sharing your screen and start your presentation when you're ready.
Okay. Hello, everyone. So my name is Eliya. I'm from Facebook Tel Aviv. I'm from Tel Aviv University. Today I'm going to talk about voice separation with an unknown number of multiple speakers. Basically, how we can separate the voices with deep learning. This is a joint work with TOCID and Leo Wolf from Facebook research. Okay, so the outline of the presentation is this. At the beginning, I'm going to talk about the problem setting. And then I'm going to show about the pair of work. And then we're going to talk about our model and the new loss terms. And then we will see which data set we use to train our model and to check it. And then we will see the results. After that, we will see how we can move from known number of speakers to unknown number of speakers. And also how we can improve the result with a test time augmentation. And then I'm going to summary. Okay, so problem setting. The problem setting is that we have a multiple speaker that talking simultaneously, and we have a single microphone that record them. And we want to do a blind source separation. Basically, we want to get the speech from each one of the speakers. So let's hear an example. This is the mixture of people that are talking together. Okay, and we want to separate each one of the speaker and get them. So this is the first speaker.
It also owns three state business magazines in Florida, comma, Georgia, and Arizona, period.
This is the second speaker.
The NASD released short interest figures for the first time November 25th for all stocks carried on NASDAQ automated quotation system.
And this is the third speaker.
The company said it would begin a double quote Dutch auction double quote later this week for as many as 40 million shares.
Okay. So our goal is to estimate C different input sources, SJ, where J is going to be from one to C, and given a source signal, X, that is composed from this multiple speaker, SI, and CI is a scaling factor for each one of the speakers. This is a fully supervised case, where our dataset is a tuples of the input mixed signal and the ground truth for each one of the speakers. No speaker identity is provided in this data set. Okay, so pair work. Traditionally, speech separation and voice separation were done with digital signal processing techniques. For example, winning filtering, MVDR, independent vector analysis, which called IVA, and so on. Recently, deep learning approaches were applied to this task. For example, the first major network that they applied to the waveform domain was the TASNET, which was which called the time domain audio separation networks for real time single channel speech separation. And after that was by the same author was published a second network that called ConfTASNET, which is suppressing the ideal time frequency magnitude masking for speech separation. And after that was the dual path RNA, which was taking the ConfTASNET and improved it with some LSPM networks and get a better result. So all of these networks basically has this form. At the input was the mixture waveforms. You can see it in here. It has an encoder, which was a convolutional layer. And then it has some separation networks that output the masking. The masking were applied to the output of the encoder. And then the result is moved for some decoder. And then we get the separated waveforms. Okay, so right now I'm going to talk about our model and how we can do the separation with deep learning. So we have at the beginning an encoder network E, which you get as an input the mixture and output the latent representation Z. The encoder networks basically, this is a 1D convolutional layer with the kernel size L, and as divided into R overlapping chunks of length K, and we call it V. And then we take this V tensor and fade it into a separation network Q. The separation network Q has V block of RNNs, and the odd blocks are applying along the time dimension, and the even blocks are applying to the chunking dimension. After that, we have a one-by-one convolutional layers applied to produce the C output channels. And lastly, we applied the overlapping end method to output the waveform. So this is the overall model. We can see at the beginning the mixture of the audio signal. And then we see the encoder, which is a 1D convolutional layers. We see here the output tensor. And then we do the chunking. We can see here the 3D tensor. And then we have this block of the RNN. We call it move cut. We will see later what this means. And after multiple blocks of move and cut blocks, we have the decoder, and then we do the overlapping end, and we have an estimation for each one of the speakers. We can also see that we applied the decoder multiple times after each one of the blocks, and we can also apply the loss term after each one of the blocks. We will see about this more later. Okay, so the modern cut blocks, basically this is the two separated LSTM networks, M1 and M2. Basically, we get the input tensor V, we apply the M2 networks and M1 networks, and we do an element wise product. And then we concat the input tensor to this multiplication. And then we do some linear projection PI and get the output tensor. We also do a skip connection after each block. You can see it in here. Basically, we have the input tensor. We apply two LSTM. We multiply the output of each one of them. And then we concat the result with the input tensor. And then we apply some the linear projection. And then we have this skip connection. Okay, so in order to train these networks, so our goal is to minimize the scaling variance signal to noise ratio. This is called SISNR. Basically, this is the ratio between the signal and the noise. We can see here that the signal is the correlation between the output of the network and the ground truth. Normalized by the power of the signal. And also the noise basically is the difference between the ground truth and the output of the networks. We also apply the permutation invariant loss. Basically, we don't know at each output which one of the speaker is going to be. So basically, we need to run all of the permutation and to select the best permutation according to the network output. We can see it in here. We try all of the permutation, all of the pi c permutation, and choose the permutation that give us the maximum of the SISNR loss. And as we see earlier, we have this multi-loss. Basically, we apply the loss after each one of the BR moon blocks. We can see it in here. This is the sum. Okay. We also have a perceptual loss. This is the ID loss. It's going to be like this. We have the G networks, which is the speaker recognition model, and which output an embedding of the speaker. We also have the F operator, which is an SDFT operation. And we also have a segmentation of the audio signal. Basically, what we are going to do, we're going to take the output of the networks, apply an SDFT, and then apply some speaker embedding networks. And then we want that at each channel, the embedding of the speaker should be consistent with the embedding of the ground truth. Basically, what we want to do is that the networks should make the speaker consistent. Because we see that if we don't do this, then we have sometimes that the networks start to output the first speaker and then output the second speaker. And we don't want that the network do this. So we have this perceptual loss. So this is how the objective loss function looks like. We have in here the R model, and we have the audio signal, the outputs. R model produces, for example, two speakers, two outputs, and then we move it to the permutation invariant loss with the ground truth and calculate the permutation invariant loss. We also, from the permutation invariant loss, calculated the optimal permutation, move it to the ID loss, the perceptual loss. And then we calculate this perceptual loss from the ground truth and from the output of our model. Okay. For data set, in order to evaluate our method, we use the Wall Street Journal 2 Mix and Wall Street Journal 3 Mix. This is a known data set for the speech separation problem. And basically, the Wall Street Journal mix is a clean data set, and we also test it on WAM and WAM-R data set. Basically, this is a data set with the noisy and the noise and the reverberation areas. And we also further expand the Wall Street Journal mix data set to 4 and 5 speakers, which called Wall Street Journal 4 mix and Wall Street Journal 5 mix. You can find them in this link. Okay, so this is the result. Before we get to the result, I should say that all of the results are reported in scale invariant signal to noise ratio. This is called SISNR loss. And this is the term. Okay, so for Wall Street Journal dataset, the clean dataset, we can see here the result for 2 speakers, 3 speakers, 4 speakers, and 5 speakers. You can see, for example, that our model achieved state-of-the-art result for all of the number of speakers. You can see here that for 5 speakers, we get an improvement over 2 dBs. And we can see also here in the 4 speaker that we get an improvement for almost 2.5 dBs and so on. Let's hear an example. This is a mixture of 4 speakers that are talking.
The New York stock corporation.
As you can hear, this is a very noisy record. And then we can hear the output of our model. This is the first one.
Constant Partners of New York said it has a 6.8% stake in Gillette and Macy's.
And this is the second output.
The New York Stock Exchange Composite Trading Friday, the company stock closed at 23 points.
This is the third output.
Sales in stores open more than 1 year increased 6.7%, $10.5 million.
And this is the fourth output.
Recently, people who tested positive joined a support group that has sprung up across the country in the past year.
Okay, So we also run an ablation analysis. Basically, we want to know which part of our model give improvement, or what is the improvement from each part of our model. You can see, for example, in the last row, we can see our complete model in the result. And if what happened if we remove the ID loss? For example, we can see here the degradation. That if we remove the ID loss, we get a small degradation, like for five speaker of 0.3 dBs. But if we look and see that if we remove the multi-loss, we get a greater degradation in the performance. For example, if you look at about the five speakers, we can see here that we get a degradation of almost over 1 dB. Okay. We also measure the effect of the ID loss. We calculate how many switches between, if you look about just one output channel and look how many times the speaker flip in the same channel, which is not good. And you see, for example, that if we use our model without the ID loss, it happened like this. And if we apply our ID loss, we have degradation in this bad phenomena in 2%. We also measure our model in the one data set, which is the noisy in the reverberation data set. We can see here that for the one data set, we improve the result over 1.5 dBs. And for one data set, we improve the result with the same almost 2 dBs. This data set are for two speakers that talk simultaneously. Let's see some examples. So this is the mixture of the input of one data set. This is the first output of our model.
But on October 31st, there were press reports that coal.
And this is the second output of our.
The diversified utility provides gas and electric service.
Okay, and this is, for example, the input from the WAM-R dataset. Okay, this is the first output.
The enormous amounts of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere caused this high pressure.
And this is the second output.
But excluding fuel and food, comma, the index probably rose 0.4% or zero.
Okay. So now we will see how we can move from a known number of speakers to unknown number of speakers. So we ask ourselves, what happened if we feed to the network that separated five speakers, a recording of two speakers? So this is the input.
Recognition
but on October 31st, the press reports that Colbert wouldn't increase offer in rivers, sales, and
rivers, but it might be withdrawn. Federal government said.
Okay, so this is the first output. As you can hear, this is a noise and silence output. This is the second output. Also, this is a noise and silent output. This is the third output. We can also hear that this is a noise and silent output. And this is the fourth output.
But on October 31st, the press reports that Colbert wouldn't increase its offer and rumors that the bid might be withdrawn. Period.
We can hear that this is the clean speaker one. And this is the five output.
Recognition said it reorganized its U.S. business into three units, sales and service, federal government said.
Okay, we can also hear that this is the clean speaker too. So our method in order to move from non-number of speaker to unknown number of speaker is to start with the model with the largest number of speakers. and then to detect how many outputs are noise or silence. So we compute the mean of this of the signal power for each one of the output source. And if we see that the mean of the signal power is very low, we know that this is a silence output. In this way, we detect the number of non-active channels, J, and then we repeat with a model of C minus J output channels. And then we continue to do that until no silence detected, or we reach the two speakers model. And we can see here the result. This is, for example, the result for our model. We can see also what happened if we use an oracle that tells us how many speakers are there in the record. You can see that this is a very small degradation. And with this small degradation, we get a complete system that can detect how many speakers was in the record and separated them. Okay. Let's talk about how we can improve the result with the test time augmentation. So we saw that if we start the separation at different points, points in time, it yields a different result. For example, if we take the same signal, but we cut the first 100 samples and we fed it to the network, we get two complete results. So our augmentation is to produce a cyclic rotation of the signal using this random location, and then average the output. So for example, if we have this signal, this is the time axis, we choose randomly some position here, and then we do some cyclic rotation and get this signal, and then feed this signal to our model, and then we do it multiple times and average the output from this multiple times. We can see here the result with the test time augmentation. So for example, we can see here, let's talk about five speakers. If you look about our model, and this is the result without an augmentation, with a zero augmentation. And we can see that if we increase the number of the averaging of the augmentation, we can see an improvement, like almost a half degree. Okay, so let's summary. So we introduced a new model architecture for speed separation. We saw that the multi-loss improved optimization due to the masking field model, our model that doesn't use the masking. We also see a novel ID loss that maintaining the speaker in each output channel. We also introduced a new dataset for four and five speakers. And our model achieves state-of-the-art performance for 2 to 5 speakers. And also our model achieved very good result for noisy reverberant environments, which was the warm and warm dataset. We also proposed a simple and effective methods for model selection to support multiple unknown number of multiple speakers. And lastly, we propose a test time augmentation to improve the robustness to the starting point. Thanks.
Thank you, Eliya, for an amazing presentation. Let me check if we have some question in live chat or in comments. No, we don't have any question. Maybe some people will write some question after all while watching this video in a record. We will probably share some links to additional materials later in a comments or description to this video. We shall see, I'm not sure. Thank you again for your time and presentation. Next presentation will be tomorrow also at 7 p.m. Moscow time, where Gianluca Di Tommaso will talk about variational method for uncertainty estimation. Don't forget to like this video if you find it interesting. If you have any questions, use comments and share this video with colleagues and friends who might be interested in today's topics. That's all for today. Have a nice time and see you all tomorrow. Bye.
Bye.